constant respiratory problems that are now epidemic. Is there any connection between this and the growing epidemic rates of other human diseases that are proven to be connected to highly toxic heavy metal exposure? Lab tests from around the globe have long since proven a mountain of heavy metals like aluminum, barium, and strontium are raining down on all of us. These metals are the primary elements named in climate engineering patents. Yes, this is connected to the dirty, dingy, often checkerboard-striped toxic mess that we see in our skies day in and day out. If you don't believe it, doesn't matter. You're still breathing this contamination with every breath, and it's building up in your body. Several dozen lab tests from Shasta and Siskiyou counties alone, about 70, I believe, prove this beyond any shadow of a doubt. Why aren't we being told? Why don't meteorologists and institutions like the Weather Channel say a word about climate engineering? Because they're owned by corporations like Blackstone and Bain Capital, corporations all connected to the umbilical of the global power structure. Does anyone believe the paid actors at the Weather Channel would tell the truth about climate engineering, knowing their jobs, or perhaps much more, depend on them saying whatever they're told to say? Perhaps we could ask Weather Channel meteorologist Nicholas Wilkin. Unfortunately, though, we can't, because he died last month in what Fox News said was, quote, an apparent suicide. His car was crashed through an Atlanta parking garage and plowed into an adjacent hotel. That's a strange way to commit suicide. But perhaps let's ask the meteorologists at the National Weather Service or the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. But no, again, because virtually all the National Weather Service and NOAA government employees are still under a federal gag order. Don't believe me, please. Investigate it for yourself. If you're willing to look at the truth, if you want to see meteorologists going to unimaginable lengths of lying to try and explain away the completely unprecedented and completely engineered weather scenarios that are now the norm, watch the Weather Channel for a while. Connect the dots. Watch the behavior of the Weather Channel actors as they give truly an ever more complex and implausible fabricated explanation for weather scenarios that are historically unprecedented and meteorologically impossible without the climate engineering factor. Again, we have engineered snowstorms happening in the West, with the center of those storms, like one I mentioned last week, winter storm, quote, Kayla, the center of the low pressure of a, quote, winter storm pushing 80 degrees with tornadoes on the, quote, warm side of the storm. Where is our sense of reason? This is not normal. We have massive temperature whiplash fluctuations from 50, 60 degrees in a single day. This is extremely devastating to the biosphere, and this can't happen naturally. It's from chemical ice nucleation related to weather modification. Please look it up. Look up every term I state. You'll find lots of data if you choose to look. As the public wakes up to the climate engineering nightmare, the crimes of climate engineering, I believe they'll hold accountable as accomplices all those who have lied to hide the geoengineering insanity. Perhaps trials like those held in Nuremberg.